Excuse me, Mr. Perkins, but I've just been tallying up Mr. Worthen's bill and it comes to £54.
I'll mention it to him, Mr. Grimes.
Mr. Lee, is Mr. Moncrief aware that he's a shade behind in his grocery bill?
I shall apprise him of the fact at my earliest opportunity.
Does Mr. Moncrief know he still owes £30 for piano lessons?
And Mr. Worthen still owes me £65 for the bank. It's come to a pretty pass when gentlemen consider it the thing not to pay their debts.
Consider gentlemen. If the rich were to suddenly pay their bills, there'd be cause for real distress. And you would suddenly find yourselves in a stupefying, stultifying, terrifying, bloody awful mess.
What are you talking about?
What do you mean a mess?
It's all quite simple. Your accounts would be in a jumble, your ledgers all in a hash.
For the debts of the aristocracy go back 4 years, our economy would crumble and the Bank of England crash. If the upper class were not always in arrears, the son inherits the father's debt in families patrician. And though this system puts you in a ticklish position, it nevertheless gives one a sense of British tradition. Gives one a noble sense of British tradition.
So you see, gentlemen, you should be singing the praises of the aristocracy.
Come, raise your cup to the upper classes whom we revere.
They stand for all we hold so dear.
Come, raise your cup for the rules to which they seldom adhere. But they've a right to break them, since it's they who make them. So come, raise a cup of cheer.
I hate to seem demanding, it leaves me close to tears, but I waited for their checks to come for 13 years.
They leave their bills outstanding, and it may afford them laughs, but I am left in quite bereft with a pile of autographs.
They call themselves the wealthy class, and what a definition. That they have any means at all is purely supposition. To remain the idle unemployed is their supreme ambition, and we say, hey, British tradition.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, why we couldn't manage without the aristocracy. Think of them from a purely ornamental standpoint. Consider the colour they lend the English countryside, punting on the Thames in their summer finery, rowing at Henley in their boaters and blazers and old school ties. Come, come, gentlemen.
Come, raise your cup
to the upper classes whom we revere.
Hurrah!
They stand for all.
Pip, pip.
We hold so dear, come raise your cup for the rules to which they seldom adhere.
Here's to the man who's gentle in the top percentile, where cash is incidental, it's so sparse. Come raise your cup up to him, play the farce.
Then shove it up, then all three up, up.
Please, oh please, dear fellow, don't be cross. When you're dealing with the upper,